What's up, MetaNerdz? This video is all about the Kaminoan Observation Ship. This ship, along with the KE-8, are things you might not have even seen, or if you did, you might not have realized that they are actually ships. This repulsor Zeppelin is so obscure that there are no official stats on it, but we can use these pics to get some numbers, and then talk about how it was used. On my screen, I was lucky to find that this guy was 1 millimeter across, and the ship length was around 16 centimeters, when you take into account that we aren't looking at this ship straight on. The average width of a human is 45 centimeters, and Kaminoans are about as wide as humans, so using this we get 160 times 45 centimeters, for a total of 72 meters, or 236 feet. Although that sounds small at first, it would mean that this ship is only 4 meters longer than a pair of YT-1300s. But what makes me more confident that this is the length is when you consider that a GR-75 medium transport was only 90 meters long, and the observation ship would be exactly 2 MTTs in length. So 72 meters isn't that small. It might just be that we often underestimate how big the Falcon is. Using this length, we can come over to a cross-section of the military complex and see that it had a height of 52 meters, or 171 feet, making it about half a Zillow Beast, or about as tall as an AT-AT standing on another AT-AT in order to act as a landing pad for an LAAT. This cross-section shows us how the observation ship worked in concert with the KE-8 to watch over the clones, with the enforcer ships being docked in the central spire, which also contain the rooms where the clones receive their arms and armor. And remember that this image just shows one sliver of the circular structure that was the Tipoca City Military Complex, and then consider that there were many of these buildings, and the Kaminoans didn't just clone Jango Fett copies for the Republic. And you can see how these big blimps helped to provide a reminder for their products that they were being watched at all times. I don't mean to imply that this was oppressive, or that clones felt like they were in prison. In fact, it is a testament to the Kaminoan skills that the vast majority of clones were the ideal patriotic soldier, ready to lay down their life for the Republic, even though they had no relationship to it. I just believe that having a ship like this floating overhead had to have some sort of psychological effect, especially when you consider that the clones were aware of rumors that some of their brothers would disappear in the middle of the night after a subpar performance, instances that I definitely want to cover in another video. These observation ships would mostly contain specialists in clone behavior, but it could also contain potential clients who would float around and see the sheer scale of the Kaminoan operations, and perhaps most importantly, the level of control exerted over their units. If they wanted to take a closer look, located under the main repulsor array, this gondola could detach and allow what I would assume to be VIPs to break off and explore this megastructure on their own without interrupting the observations being made from the experts in the main part of this ship. And of course, if any issues came up, then the KE-8 could deliver its shock prod accordingly. So that's it for the Kaminoan observation ship, the thing you saw, but might not have known was the ship. And the only cool behind-the-scenes fact is that it is in the video game Star Wars Republic Commando, and was first named in the book Inside the Worlds of Star Wars, Attack of the Clones. But more important than all that, remember, the Greys are always watching, and the Force will be with you. Always.